So I've got this note to myself literally at the top of my script, and it's pronounce lieutenant, not lieutenant. But you know what? I feel like I've spoken to teachers who say lieutenant as well. So I'm like, you know what? If teachers say lieutenant and they're not too fussed about it, then I shouldn't be either. But you know, now that I've got that there, I will say lieutenant for the rest of this video. So kudos to myself for writing that down as a reminder, because in one of my previous videos, I think I was pronouncing it lieutenant, and there was only as I was editing it and I was like, oops. Anyways, as you probably know, we're talking about the lieutenant today. If you don't know me, my name is Lisa. I have been a VC English tutor for 10 years now. Yes, I know I look young, but I'm actually much older under the skin. So a world of knowledge right here. Basically, we're going to do something a little bit different today. I'm really excited about this because as I was trying to write up this script for the lieutenant, I realized that there are heaps of study guides and pieces out there about the lieutenant, about lieutenant, where you've got, you know, the same themes, it says the same thing about the characters. So I really wanted to be able to offer you guys something new and fresh. So what I'm going to do today is actually talk about the literary devices that the author is using. And what I've done is I've chosen a particular passage that is one of my favorites, and I'm literally digging into it. So think of me as holding a, a microscope, and I'm zooming in at each individual sentence and plucking out the words that really add meaning to what Grenville is trying to do. So this particular way of analyzing a book is very similar to how you would do things in literature. It's actually a technique that I learned from literature, and I found that language analysis or analyzing argument kind of does the same thing, in that you're looking at a micro level at each individual word, each phrase, for example, or even a sentence, and seeing how the construction of that adds value to what Grenville's ideas and themes explore. So if you are studying literature, then you know what I'm talking about. But if you're an English student and this is something new for you, this is a part of the criteria that I believe really high graded students or high performing students always try to go for. So if you take on board some of these skills, I think it will really help lift up your essays. Let's just get into it. So this passage is from page 258 and 270, and it's the chapter where Silk leads the men, including Rook, to Botany Bay tribe village to capture the natives. Let's investigate the phrase, a piece of theater. In writing a piece of theater, Grenville shows that this is all just an act for Silk, a display that has been rehearsed and ready with no consideration towards the natives. Another quote is, the surgeon got the troop of men lined up and it clanged out of the settlement like a clumsy clockwork toy of many segments which would twitch its way over the floor until the spring ran down. Grenville uses onomatopoeia when she describes the men clanking out of the settlement. The word reminds us how these men are noisy, unpolished, unrefined. This representation of the men is what makes us, as readers, realize Grenville's contempt for their plan. Kangaroo Ground, a pleasant, park-like grassy expanse with large trees at intervals and a graceful slope to the land. In juxtaposition with the uninviting description of the men, nature is depicted with tender and loving words. It's described as pleasant and graceful, heightening the disturbance the settlers bring about to the land as they clank and twitch, as mentioned in the previous quote. Another quote is machinery of empire. The metaphor machinery removes all humanity from the empire constructed by the European settlers. It moves only like clockwork, as previously mentioned, and the significance of one person is reduced to nothing, as long as they can contribute to the greater plan of entrapping the natives. This realigns with our understanding of Rook as somebody who no one really understands or tries to understand for his individuality. Rather, he's just another tool in the clockwork. Rook found an embayment among tall bushes that was like a room with walls that shifted in the breeze from the sea. Tall bushes that was like a room with walls is a simile. Rook feels a sense of belonging amongst nature, whereas the men rely towards man-made items by using their packs and handkerchief when resting. In conjunction with the wars also, his gravitation towards nature divides Rook, our protagonist, from the remainder of his crew and reminds us of his betrayal to the men in his own values and beliefs. Rook led his men across a tangled area of sand and rope-like strands of grass, heaped and valleyed in ways that could have been designed expressly to make progress difficult. This description again showcases how the men don't belong on this new land. In a metaphorical sense, the land's tangles and rope-like strands prevents them from reaching their target. This showcases Grenville's disapproval because the men are just forcing themselves through. Werengen, caught up to them, hardly out of breath. His physical fitness is beyond that of the European settlers, showing that this is his land, it's where he's grown up and he feels comfortable and at home here. He, unlike the settlers, don't have to struggle through tangles and rope-like strands because this is his home. Even nature welcomes him. This attack on the village would make a good chapter in Silk's narrative. He had orchestrated an impressive performance. The words good chapter, narrative, orchestrated, and impressive performance all culminate to show how for Silk, his presence in the new colony, his obligations to the governor are all theatre. He is more obsessed with creating a story worth reading rather than seeing the damage, pain, and suffering inflicted upon the natives. So if you don't get it already, the reason why looking at literary techniques and metalanguage, link up above if you're not too sure, is because rather than just relying on traditional quotes, where we just kind of take the quote, put it into our paragraph and use that as evidence, there are different angles that you can look at that certain quote. So whether it's saying that it's a metaphor or a narrative perspective or imagery, there's certain reasons why authors use the words that they use. There are specific choices being made behind the scenes that if we can show the examiner we understand, then you're in a good spot. So that's my analysis of a couple of pages from The Lieutenant. If you found this style of video helpful, let me know down in the comments section below, because that will let me know that I should do a few more of these type of videos. That's it from me today. I will see you guys next week. Bye.